Of course, our next guest is a familiar voice on Talk Sport and Talk Radio Network. He absolutely huge Aston Villa fan, indeed director of the Aston Villa Supporters Trust, broadcaster, funny person, all-round good bloke, and Aston
Villa. What a build-up.
And hopefully recovered from yesterday. It's Johnny Gould. Hi, Johnny.
You know what?
Hi, Johnny.
Say hi, Mickey.
And a smile as long as London Bridge, by the way.
You're not wrong. I mean, really, this is what football's about. It's about dreaming. It's about realising those ambitions. And this, for Aston Villa, we really have gone down the pan in a Blackpool fashion of the 1970s. Burnley before they came back. You know, the big clubs went down, they came back. This happened a number of times to Aston Villa, believe me. When we make a return to the Premier League like this, it is really, really prized.
Because if you had the choice, you'd always come, if you knew it was going to happen, you'd always come up through the playoffs, because you get the big day at Wembley and the excitement.
Trophy.
Norwich, for, you know, the champions. Sheffield United, you know, brilliant there up, but who even remembers how they got up now? Whereas we'll always remember this game. How important was it for Aston Villa in the last year of the parachute payments to actually get up?
It was an absolute matter of urgency. And at the Villa Trust AGM, which was well attended at the Holt Suite at Villa Park, our new chief executive at the time, Christian Perslow, laid it to us straight. He said, going up this season is not part of the plans. It will be gravy. But then he said, as you say, the parachute money had come to an end. Aston Villa, one of the most well-screened championship teams, earned £7 million from television revenue last season. OK, Leeds United, £6.5 million. And then you look at clubs like Birmingham City, £4 and £5 million pounds. Bournemouth, Huddersfield Town, Cardiff City, you name it, £100 million.
Yeah.
And that's the equation. And of course, there are clubs stuck in perjury, aren't there?
Leeds United being the most obvious example. Yeah. Ipswich, of course, have stopped being stuck. They've gone the other way.
Well, that could have happened to us at the beginning of the season. I mean, really, we are talking about almost a decade of development at this football club in a period of time which goes back to October, the appointment of Dean Smith. We started the season Jurassic. Keith Wyness, Tony Shearer admitted, we haven't got any money. We've spent next season's parachute money. What?
Yeah.
I can't get the money out of China. Tottenham have come for Jack Grealish. They're offering £3 and a bag of Marley's. Oh, yeah, and Josh Onoma. It was, honestly. Mm-hmm.
But Johnny, when they employed Dean Smith, right, Brucey went, as director of the Aston Villa Supporters Club, what was the feel behind Dino getting the job? And also, it didn't start too well for him, did it?
We had a bit of a bounce, as you have with the new manager, but you're right, Mickey. Things did start going down the pan. And if you look at some of Dean's record at Brentford and Walsall, there are moments like that. Believe me, you know, when you have two sides in the Europa League final and two sides in the Champions League final next week and the week after, we're going to get mullered once or twice at Man City. I don't fancy our chances up there very much. I don't fancy our chance at hashtag Spurs new stadium. Look at this lovely place. Oh, Harry Kane. Oh, never mind. We're going to lose at home. We might even lose at home to Bournemouth along the way. And that is where we need to remember that, you know, Dean Smith's potential is there. He's a homegrown boy. He's got a lot of equity in the bank. We really love this guy.
Yeah.
And he can be our Shankly. I really believe that.
I mean, right? The start of that 10-match run, the 10 successive
wins. It's a record, isn't it?
I mean,
it's 144 years.
Yeah.
I mean, they were going nowhere, Aston Villa. They were going to finish mid-table. So it's not perhaps as bizarre as when Crystal Palace went from the bottom three to the playoffs under Ian Dowie all those years ago. Simon Jordan has told me to say that. What caused the turn? Can you identify a game or a moment where suddenly Aston Villa clicked? Or was it the return of Grealish to his best shape and form? What was it?
I was there for the moment, and it was when we played Derby County at home in the league. And Dean Smith said, he may be back, he may be back, he's back. And then it appeared an hour before kickoff, Jack Grealish, captain. And he did an England manager thing, didn't he? Peter Taylor brought Beckham in, made him the skipper. Mm-hmm. And Grealish is, you know, the life and soul, you know, the Ravens at the Tower for Aston Villa. And not only that, you know, normal players, yeah, get into a sort of rhythm of match fitness over a period of games. He's lithe, he's small, he's mobile, he loves collecting the ball and trying to beat three or four men for a bit of fun. And he was on his game immediately, and he scored the extra set.
Johnny,
beautiful
he,
goal.
What the kid's been through as well, could have gone to Spurs at one point. He was live on TalkSport yesterday and said it looked like it was on. Even he thought he was going to Spurs. But to turn that round, like you said, captain, and the Birmingham game, when he came through that, and not just, you know, playing well, scored in the win, but he got a dig there off a supporter. And the way he handled that, and the temperament, and the way he's almost grown up this season and peaked with Villa, and that'll put him in great stead for next season. Is he going
to
stay?
Mickey, you've said it all for me, and the answer to that final question is, yes, he will. Yeah. Because for all the demands that Leicester City and Crystal Palace are putting on us now, Sawiris, who's one of our co-owners, one of the richest men out of Egypt, said, we don't want your money. And not only that, it's homegrown money now with our homegrown player. There is nothing at Bournemouth or Crystal Palace or Leicester City, and all due respect to the Champions League finalist Tottenham, that they can give to this man who has a love and a kinship, a literally a kinship with his supporters. His great-grandfather won the FA Cup with Villa in 1900-something or other, I think. There's something very, very special. And we're in the Premier League. Why on earth would Jack Grealish not sign a new improved deal with Aston Villa, having just committed them to $5 million a year?
I'm sure he will. How is it important? Is it embarrassing, the royal connection to Aston Villa these days?
It's beautiful.
Oh, everything is beautiful in Johnny's mind.
I've got to say, I'm in love.
Have you met him?
I met John Carew. I touched John Carew yesterday.
That was surreal, wasn't it?
It was.
That was surreal, the picture of royalty hugging John Carew.
It's not the first time they've had a little hug as well.
Tough,
they hugged when we beat Cardiff last season with another Grealish extra set. It was a bit too late for promotion last season. Of course, we lost to Fulham in the playoff final. But no, Prince William, it's fantastic. I mean, I don't think you're supposed to be biased to one club. But not many people know, you know, when Charles and Di got divorced, Di moved in above a curry shop in Spark Hill.
That's why he's connected. Now, you possibly Freudian, you just mentioned the great mystery and the great danger of Aston Villa's wonderful triumph yesterday, Fulham. Fulham went up last year from the same match, with all guns blazing, got into the Premier League. They've got a rich owner too. Splashed cash left, right and centre. Abandoned the team that got them promoted.
Bought 85 players.
And were the worst team in the Premier League last year. I know Huddersfield got less points, but they had no players. The worst team, the worst team spirit, the worst organisation was Fulham. How do Aston Villa avoid that, Johnny?
And they had Schürrle and Babel in their team, two world-class players. I mean, Schürrle scored the winning goal in the World Cup final. Yeah. Did he not?
He did. Well, the first and Mitrovic is a fine player too.
There you go, another Newcastle United player who went in Fulham and big, big money.
Yeah, there's dangers, isn't there?
There are dangers there, but you know what? We go up with the spine of a team. Some are on loan and some need to have contracts renewed. You know, we've got Mings, who is a top-level player, definitely deserved of a Premier League career, possibly even an England cap. We have McGinn, who's an excellent hybe, who came in having won the Scottish Cup.
I thought you were nuts about Liverpool, but this is really outstanding. This is outstanding stuff.
Yeah. And of course, McGinn for the goal.
Is it quicker? Is there anybody in Aston Villa who doesn't deserve to play for Brazil just now?
Well, we've got the Scottish Cafu as well. Although Alan Hutton will be leaving, I think, at the end of this season. And God bless him, he's had nearly 10 years at Villa. But we've got the spine. My one reservation with McGinn and Grealish and Mings at the back and with Tammy Abraham, who scored 27 goals up front, is the gap between scoring goals in the Championship and in the Premier League is a little bit stark. Tammy Abraham sometimes hits the band or other than the banjo.
Tammy may be wanted at Chelsea next season with their transfer ban.
There is a possibility. And if we have to say goodbye to one player, then it would be Tammy Abraham. But boy, oh boy, we need to spend a few quid on the front line. Codger as well might have a chance.
There's one name for you.
Go on.
Certain Mr. Sturridge. Back in Birmingham.
Maybe.
On a free transfer.
Maybe.
There's one. I just tossed that in for you there, just for Villa fans to think about.
Maybe
he's going on.
Anyway, I think it's beholden us not to start talking at this stage about what might go wrong. Just to say, well done to Aston Villa.
Thank you so much.
You know, one always feels for the Derby County fans. I do anyway. But well done to Aston Villa.
We know what it's like.
Yeah, and hopefully, a club that's been badly run for a decade can get itself sorted out now. and enjoy themselves, including and the good work that you do there, Johnny. Thanks for coming in.
Pleasure, Danny, and good luck with your date with Destiny, because it really is, and you've got one and all, haven't you?
Yes.
Yeah. Are you going to stay friends next week?
Always friends.
Yeah. Always it's football, friends. You know, it'll be all right. You heard there from Johnny Gould, who is the director of the Aston Villa Supporters Trust. Pleasure. And this is Kelly and Quinn in for Hawksby and Jacobs on TalkSport with Greene King. Grab your mates and head to your local Greene King pub to watch the Europa League final. Plus, save 10% on your drinks all night using your Greene King season ticket app, your home for pub sport.